In this video, I'll test which filaments can be combined particularly well in one component and which ones should better not be mixed. To do this, I used my tensile test to analyze all the possible combinations of the most common filaments. Based on these results, I will then show you possible applications from PETG with PLA support structures to combining TPU with PETG and a possible solution for avoiding warping using a thin layer of PLA under ABS parts. Stay tuned here at JanTec Engineering. Multi-material 3D printers like the Prusa XL, various IDEX machines or multiplexing systems like AMS or MMU3 are becoming increasingly popular. In addition to multicolor prints, mainly used for text or figures, different material types can be combined. This opens up new manufacturing possibilities, especially for technical parts. A great example is this one-piece tire from Prusa, which combines particularly stiff and soft rubber-like materials. I started wondering which filaments combine particularly well and which materials don't bond and could be used as support structures. On the internet, you'll often find generic statements claiming that PLA works well with PETG supports or that TPU bonds well to PLA. I wanted to investigate this a bit more scientifically, which is why I came up with a small test setup. For the test, I built my own motorized tensile test rig that can be used to tear various samples. Different modular fixtures can be mounted via these clamps, which then hold different 3D printed test specimens. The NEMA 17 stepper motor with 14:1 planetary gearbox then pulls the sample apart. The force applied to the sample is measured and plotted continuously by this load cell. For the samples, I used the work of Stefan aka CNC Kitchen as a reference. They offer a larger surface area than conventional test bones, 26.4 square millimeters to be precise, and can be printed quickly and easily. These samples are particularly suitable for this experiment because you simply print one half, then change the filament, and then print the second half from a different filament on top. Now a brief overview of the choice of filaments. In this video, I will focus on the four most popular material types: PLA, PETG, TPU and ABS. Feel free to let me know in the comments if you would also be interested in a test with special materials such as nylon, PP or PC. Specifically, I have Prusament PLA in green, Prusament PETG in grey, Fiberlogy Fiberflex 40D TPU in red and Nobufil ABSX in Astro Black. Some of the filaments had already been unpacked and used, which is why I wanted to dry them before printing the samples. This way I can ensure that the results are accurate and comparable. I used the SUNLU S4 filament dryer for this. After drying, I could have printed directly from the box using PTFE tubes, but since none of these filaments is really highly hygroscopic, I simply loaded the filaments into the printer without sealing them. I chose the Prusa XL for printing the samples because this way I only have to load all four filaments once and the printer takes care of combining the filaments on its own. However, my original idea of printing all 10 samples at the same time turned out to be rather bad because the print bed temperatures vary greatly and the printer would have to change the tools multiple times per layer. So I created 10 G-codes and started them one by one manually. Over 2 days, this took less time than I thought. All samples came out really well. For the experiment, I mounted the appropriate holders to my tensile tester and teared all samples one after the other. Here you can see the results. Let's analyze them together. As I already knew from the previous tests, PLA has by far the best layer adhesion. TPU stretched and eventually slipped out of the sample holders. However, this value is not so important for the combinations. Surprisingly, The adhesion between PETG and TPU, as well as between PLA and ABS, was quite good. The idea of using PLA as a support material for PETG or the other way around is confirmed by my test. Before I show some sample applications based on the results, I'd like to thank the sponsor of today's video. JLC 3DP provides cost-effective 3D printing services in a wide range of materials. In the past, I've used their SLA, SLS and MJF printing services to produce components for my tensile test. Now, JLC 3DP also offers WJP full color printing, a revolutionary new technology. White jet process is an advanced white ink 3D printing technology that combines digital imaging and material deposition techniques to create full color, multi-material, voxel level 3D printing effects. The sample prints on the website looked very impressive, which is why I've already ordered a sample printed using WJP technology from JLC 3DP. It's on its way to me and I'll be showing it off in one of my next videos, so stay tuned. In the meantime, explore the possibilities of full color WJP printing at jlc3dp.com and check out the link below for up to $60 in new user vouchers. As I just mentioned, PLA and PETG adhere extremely poorly to each other. Therefore, they are very good to use as a support material for each other. To test this, I designed this chain in Fusion 360. Anyone who has ever removed more complex support structures by hand will now be able to imagine how time-consuming and frustrating it would be to get these off a PETG component. Therefore, I selected a soluble full option in Prusa slicer, which means that the chain is printed in PETG and the supports in PLA. The print went perfectly. The PLA supports stuck to the PETG part just well enough for everything to be printed together without any problems. Removal was really easy, it took me less than 30 seconds. Another advantage is that you can print the supports in a different, easily distinguishable color, such as green on gray here, so you can easily identify what is support and what should be part of the component. This also makes it easy to quickly spot and remove any small strings that may have been left over. Prior to these tests, I had already printed various bones with joints from printables as a combination of PLA and TPU. It should be noted that the two materials are not truly stacked on top of each other, but connected through a clever design of spheres and rods. Therefore, it does not really matter how well or poorly the combined filaments adhere to each other. However, for the support structures, it's interesting to combine PETG with PLA. Since the tests had shown that TPU and PETG adhere very well to each other, I wanted to make a useful test print for these materials as well. I came up with the idea of printing a phone case that is hard on the outside and soft on the inside. I downloaded the model for my phone from printables and simply painted it in the Prusa slicer for multi-material printing. This allowed me to print the inside in TPU and the outer layers in PETG. Once again, the print worked great. PETG and TPU adhere very well to each other as expected and the case fits perfectly. Finally, and maybe the highlight of this video, combining PLA and ABS. Since these two materials stuck surprisingly well together, I had the idea of printing ABS parts on a thin layer of PLA. The idea was to reduce bed adhesion issues and warping. For testing, I printed the stealth burner body with the first layer being PLA and the printer then switching to ABS. Doing this, I noticed another advantage, which is that the printing bed is heated to about 60 degrees Celsius when PLA is used, or not at all. ABS, on the other hand, should be printed with a bed temperature of at least 100 degrees C. Not every printer can do this, and power consumption is significantly higher, especially for longer prints. To investigate this idea further, I downloaded the warping test from Extrutrim and first printed it completely out of ABS as usual. Here, once with 65 degrees Celsius bed, that doesn't work at all, of course. then regularly with 100 degrees, here, as expected, relatively strong warping. Then, with my trick and a layer of PLA, the warping was very minimal. Over time, I tried more and also got initial feedback on Twitter. There is still a lot to test and optimize here. That's why I'm working on a detailed video about this method and would love to get feedback or ideas. So please subscribe to not miss the video and tell me about your ideas in the comments. Thanks for watching. Here you can subscribe to the channel and watch more of my videos.